This is the day the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it, because God is on his throne and he is in charge of this universe. Let's come around God's word and let him open a door of hope for us each hour. The world may not have any peace, but the Lord who lives within us grants us his peace. In this hour, everybody must do their own research and engage in critical thinking. Moral relativism and identity politics are deceptive, and many people are lost with no definite direction. A recent shocking poll said that there's a great rise in the number of persons who have no religious affiliation whatsoever. They're just drifting. I believe we're living in the last days of world history, leading up to the second coming of Jesus. So we've got to be awake and alert. One of the signs of the last days is the shocking immodesty and degradation of women. It's a strange irony because our times are supposed to be all about emancipation of women and the empowerment of women. However, despite strides made in recent generations concerning women's rights and equality, both women and men have never been in a more desperate need for excellent role models. And thankfully, we can find those role models here in the Bible. Young people in particular are desperately in need of role models. And certainly, two of the best female examples from the pages of the Bible are Ruth, a Gentile, and Queen Esther, a Jewish heroine. The Bible gives us a number of female deliverers in Israel. Miriam, the sister of Moses and Aaron, the prophetess Deborah, and the housewife Yael, all were instruments in the salvation of their people during perilous episodes of history. Esther is counted among the prophetesses of Israel. Much has been made of her beauty. The truth is, she was trained how to beautify herself. Even a plain-looking woman can learn how to make herself look attractive. I appreciate the commentary on the Book of Esther by Marianne Farnham, an English Victorian Baptist. She was an educator, journalist, and lecturer at a time when women were not expected to enter public life. Marianne Farnham wrote a woman's sermon to other women in which she asked, "What is women's duty?" Well, many modern women would laugh her to scorn, but she wrote that